Wading through all the research studies looking for clear answers about nutrition could make you feel like a fish out of water. You might have heard, for example, that fat in your diet is bad. And if you're talking about saturated or trans fat, you'd be right. But there are also plenty of good fats, and a lot of them come from fish. There is a group of polyunsaturated fats called omega-3 fatty acids that are essential nutrients. Eicosapentaenoic acid, or EPA, and docosahexaenoic acid, or DHA, are two kinds that seem to be very good for us. There's a growing body of evidence that eating omega-3s, like EPA and DHA, may provide protection against a number of serious diseases, especially sudden cardiac death. It's likely that omega-3s have other benefits too, including support for the immune system, the central nervous system, and maybe even relief from rheumatoid arthritis, depression, and the slowing of the onset of dementia as we get older. We don't have all the answers yet as to why omega-3s seem to be so good for us. Research is challenging because there are both health benefits and possible drawbacks to eating foods full of omega-3s, namely fish. My patients ask me all the time about mercury and other contaminants. And it's true that some fish do contain toxins like methylmercury, dioxins, polychlorinated biphenyls, and several other pollutants. However, some seafood is also rich in selenium, an essential trace element that may protect against both cardiovascular disease and the toxic effects of mercury. You see, it is complicated. The most vulnerable are women who are or may become pregnant, nursing mothers, and young children. For them, the recommendation is to particularly avoid seafood with higher levels of mercury and other possible toxins. These include shark, swordfish, tilefish, tuna, pike, bass, and king mackerel, as well as fish from locally contaminated areas. For the general population, it's clear that the health benefits of eating certain fish far outweigh the possible risks. So how much should you have? The American Heart Association recommends people eat at least 2 servings of fish per week, especially fatty fish, to maximize our intakes of omega-3s. 1 serving is about the size of a deck of cards. Here's how you can up your intake. Incorporate more fish and seafood in your diet. The nutrients we're talking about are found mostly in fatty fish, like salmon, bluefish, mackerel, Arctic char, and in other kinds of seafood. And for those of you who eat it, it's also in algae. Even small quantities, like in stir fry and soup, make a difference. If you want to eat canned tuna occasionally, switch to chunk light to get the lowest amount of mercury of all canned tuna. Use fortified foods. Some provide EPA and DHA, and others provide plant sources of omega-3s. They're all good. Sources include fortified eggs, milk, and yogurt. Use supplements which provide EPA and DHA from algae and purified fish oil. Doses vary, and so does the bioavailability of the nutrients from supplements, so be an educated consumer. So include healthy amounts of the right kind of fish and seafood in your diet, and you'll lower your risk for a whole host of serious conditions. Now that's advice that won't stink after a few days.